Happy Friday, folks. We are 3/4 in for episode 75.
We hope you've had a great week and that you have a wonderful weekend.
Here's your PPN for the week.
To kick us off, here's your VBHS news. Congratulations to the VBHS Winter Guard for winning the Scholastic Regional A classification in the weekend's Mid-Continent Color Guard Association competition.
The VBHS Winter Guard competed against teams in Missouri, Kansas, and Arkansas and was the only team out of 34 to earn a superior rating, the highest rating that can be achieved.
The VBHS Winter Guard is a new activity at VBHS, and this was their first ever competition.
Also, congratulations to the VBHS Quiz Bowl team for advancing on to state. Joyce Ho had the second highest individual score at the tournament. Sam Swan plays fourth. Also, congratulations to teammates Colton Nichols and Anthony Corona.
I'm Brandon.
I'm Sam.
And I'm Avery, and this is Pointer Pack News Sports.
To start off this segment, I just want to say congratulations to both the boys and girls basketball team on a great season. Our boys went 13-9. I also want to say a special congratulations to senior Avery Salisbury on breaking the record for most career three-pointers made.
Congratulations to the Van Buren baseball team on getting wins Monday and Tuesday. Their record is now 3-0 on the season. Good luck to the Pointer baseball team as they play Saturday. That's right, tomorrow in a doubleheader at Rogers Heritage. The first game is at 3:30 against Batesville, and then they'll play Perigold after that one. So head up to Northwest Arkansas and support your Pointer baseball team. It's going to be a beautiful day out there, too.
Boys soccer is now 3-0 after beating Southside, Clarksville, and on Monday, Springdale. The score is 1-0 in that game Monday. Shout out to Dylan Portillo for scoring the goal. Shout out to softball. Took a tough loss 5-1 to Southside, but shout out to Haley Gervin. She hit an absolute nuke. This has been Pointer Pack News Sports.
In politics, Biden ordered an airstrike in Syria, bombing a cluster of buildings that the Pentagon said belonged to Iran-backed militias responsible for a recent attack on American troops and contractors. Biden nominated three people to the board of the United States Postal Services. If confirmed, they would give Democrats the power to oust Louis DeJoy, the minimum wage using the budget reconciliation process, potentially killing the measures from Biden's pandemic relief plan.
The House passed the Equality Act, which would extend civil rights protections to sexual orientation, gender's identity. The bill is unlikely to pass in the Senate, though. Mitch McConnell said he would absolutely support Donald Trump as the 2024 Republican nominee after calling him responsible for the Capitol riots.
More news in the U.S., specifically the military. The Army will allow female soldiers to wear ponytails and several other hairstyles in addition to the traditional tight bun, a response to the growing number of women, particularly black women, in its ranks.
According to the New York Times, roughly one-third of active duty troops and National Guard members, mostly younger personnel, have declined to take the vaccine.
Speaking of the vaccine, the Food and Drug Administration authorized Johnson & Johnson's one-shot vaccine for emergency use only on Saturday, making the third vaccine available in the U.S.
It is the first approved vaccine to require one dose instead of two. Shipments are expected to start within days, on top of millions of doses being churned out by Pfizer, BioNTech, and Moderna.
Meanwhile, Moderna will begin clinical trials for the new vaccine, which is designed to offer better protection against the highly contagious variant B.1.351.
Last week, Ghana became the first country to receive a vaccine care package from the UN-backed COVAX program. The 600,000 doses will start being administered this week.
COVAX is coordinated by the WHO, the Global Vaccine Alliance, the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovation. It aims to narrow the vaccination gap between rich and low-income countries.
In the business world, Jane Fraser takes over as CEO of Citigroup today, becoming the first woman to run a major U.S. bank.
GameStop shares shot up to 104% in a wild rally last week, sparking jumps in another meme stock like AMC and Express.
Best Buy is laying off 5,000 workers and closing more than 20 big box stores as it moves deeper into e-commerce.
AT&T is spinning out its new U.S. video business, including DirecTV, into a new $16.3 billion company called New DirecTV.
Lastly, Hasbro is dropping the Mister from its Potato Head toy this year to keep the plastic spud gender neutral.
For your global news, Iran rejected an offer to directly negotiate with the U.S. about reviving the nuclear deal that Trump exited.
At least 18 people were killed by security forces in demonstrations across Myanmar yesterday, the bloodiest day since the military took power a month ago.
Hong Kong charged dozens of people with conspiracy to commit subversion using a new national security law. It's an escalation in China's efforts to control the city.
Lastly, the U.S. has concluded the Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman approved an operation to capture or kill journalist Jamal Khashoggi, according to an intelligence report released earlier this week.
As the world's largest oil exporter, Saudi Arabia has always been influential in the global energy market, but its recent push to diversify away from the fossil fuels means it becomes a muscular player in the defense, high-tech, and even entertainment. While Biden is aiming to recalibrate the U.S.'s stance toward Saudi Arabia, he's still tiptoeing around. According to the NYT, the president isn't planning on directly penalizing NBS for his role in Khashoggi's murder because the price of alienating a geopolitical ally is too high.
Last week, digital artist Mike Winkleman, aka Beeple, will join the ranks of the best artists to name drop on a date by having a piece auctioned by Christie's today. But this is no ordinary art piece. It will be the first fully digital NFT-based artwork ever sold by a major auction house and the first to ever accept cryptocurrency as a payment option.
In music news, last week, Lady Gaga's dog walker had been shot 4 times by 2 masked men. The men had stolen both of her dogs. Gaga had a $500,000 reward, no questions asked, which quickly made the search for her lost pups easy. She's been reunited with her dogs, and her dog walker is expected to make a full recovery.
In the entertainment industry, Loki, the next Marvel Studios project for Disney Plus, will premiere in June.
Following WandaVision and The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, Loki will be the latest MCU project shift from big screen to small.
It follows the titular god of mischief, played by Tom Hiddleston, as he steps out of his brother's shadow and takes place after the events of Avengers Endgame.
Additionally, Disney Plus announced the rest of its spring and early summer slate. Here's the list in chronological order.
Big shot.
Star Wars The Bad Batch will launch May 4th. We see you, Star Wars puns.
High School Musical 2, the musical series, Season 2.
Zenimation Season 2.
The Mysterious Benedict Society.
Monsters at Work.
Turner and Hooch.
And Chip and Dale, Park Live.
All of these will premiere by July 23rd.
Lastly, for some cool news. NASA sent a secret message to Mars. Engineers hinted they had hidden a code in the parachute that landed the Perseverance rover. Within hours, puzzle enthusiasts cracked it.
The code was cracked in 6 hours by Maxine Avila, a 23-year-old computer science student in Paris, and his father, a software engineer in London. The message? Dare mighty things.
Hey everybody, it's Brandon Miller back here with some more Pointer Pack News weather. Hope you guys are having a great Friday out there. How about yesterday's weather with sunny skies and temperatures in the mid to upper 60s? Today's weather is going to be a little bit different as we're going to be seeing cooler temperatures as we're going to be in the 50s, and we're going to be seeing cloudy skies and some scattered rain showers out there. But as we look ahead to the weekend, it's going to be a beautiful one out there as Saturday and Sunday we're going to be seeing sunny skies and temperatures warming back up into the mid 60s. So, I encourage you to get out there and, of course, hit up that park or maybe go up to Northwest Arkansas and catch the Pointer baseball team play Saturday. As we look at next week's weather, Monday and Tuesday, we're going to be seeing beautiful weather out there with temperatures in the mid-60s once again and sunny skies. And as we look at Wednesday through Friday, though, we're going to be seeing those rain chances come on back. But the key thing to look at through next week is our temperatures are going to be remaining in the 60s. As we look at the world weather news, volunteers in Finland are trying to come together and build the world's largest ice carousel. This giant ice spinning disc is more than 980 feet across. Wow. So that's going to about do it for Pointer Pack News weather and this episode. I'm Brandon Miller and the rest of the PPN crew signing off.
Oh! In
Saudi Arabia. Here's your PPN for.